So the third video with Sebastian, we talked in the first videos about Vue.js, and then we started talking about Nuxt and the fact that it for different things that you have to do manually, Nuxt makes some kind of default choices for you and takes care of the different complexities. Yes. You know, the routing complexity, the building the components into JavaScript, the server rendering. So we talked about this, and we said that we are going to talk about
the modules. Nuxt module. Yeah.
Nuxt modules. What are Nuxt modules?
Nuxt module are a simple way to extend your application, your Nuxt application. So you can use it for instance, I will talk about the HTTP module. So you install it with NPM, you add it inside your list of modules, and then inside your components, inside your pages, and everywhere in your Nuxt app, you can use this .HTTP to make HTTP requests to any kind of API.
Right. The Nuxt modules, do they interact with the client side of things or server side?
Both. That's the specific area of Nuxt module. They work on both server side and client side.
So they kind of have some kind of events that they can be, it can trigger, some events can trigger Nuxt modules, and then they can render differently. How do they work?
So the Nuxt module are simply a function that is called at the beginning when running your Nuxt app, we will call every module. And these modules have access to some Nuxt API. So they can decide to add a plugin. It could be a Vue plugin. They can decide to update the Webpack configuration. And they can also listen to some hook from Nuxt internally to update some behavior. So you can also replace the Vue router from your own router, for instance, and add plugins. So you have different area with the Nuxt module.
You told me that you have a module for Apollo for doing GraphQL.
So if you want to query some GraphQL API, you can use the Nuxt Apollo module. And you install it, you add it, and inside your pages and your component, you can directly query your GraphQL API.
And do you have like some modules for, you know, the client side or for CSS, for design, all these kind of things?
Yes, we have some modules for different front-end framework. So we have a module for Tailwind CSS, another one for Vuelify. And Vue Bootstrap, so you can directly add this module and you have access to the Bootstrap component, for instance. And we also have some a Nuxt module called Nuxt Pure CSS that will automatically remove all the unused CSS for maximum performances.
But you can also have modules that integrate with Webpack, right?
Yes. Like, for instance, Nuxt Pure CSS is a module Webpack that will update your Webpack configuration.
And how do modules function? Is it you guys who develop it, or is it the community that adds it?
It's both us and the community. We started creating Nuxt module for ourselves, for the documentation, for some showcase. And the community, we started writing the documentation. And with the documentation, the community started to create their own plugins, their own modules, and share it. And we created the Nuxt-community organization on GitHub, so everyone feel free to transfer your repository. So we have an active community helping to maintain the project, to make them up to date.
Nice. So in the next video, we can talk about what are the new things that you're going to add to Nuxt, what you're working on.
For Nuxt 3, for instance.
Yeah, cool. Okay.